want to say thank you so much for coming out. Robbie Trent with the Fellowship of Christian Athletes. And today is a very somber day, one that none of us wanted to see come. But in this time of serious heartache, we want to just encourage you with some truth. So we have some football players that will just read a few passages of Scripture. We have some time of prayer, some time to remember Sam, and then you can hang out as long as you want to encourage one another and to grieve with one another. So a few of the football guys will come out, and they'll be reading passages of Scripture.
First passage can be from 1 Thessalonians 4, 13-14. It says this: "We do not want you to be uninformed, brethren, about those who are asleep, so that you will not grieve as do the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep in Jesus."
John 11:25-26. Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live, and even though they die, and whoever lives by believing in me will never die. Do you believe this?"
1 Corinthians 15:54-57 says, "When the perishable has been clothed with the imperishable, and the mortal with immortality, then the saying that is written will come true. Death has been swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, he gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ."
1 Corinthians 15:21-22. "For since death came through a man, the resurrection of the dead also comes through a man. For as in Adam all die, so in Christ all will be made alive."
Luke 23:43, as Jesus was addressing a thief on the cross, he said, "Truly I tell you today, you will be with me in paradise."
Romans 8:38-39, "For I am persuaded that neither death nor life nor angels nor principalities nor power nor things present nor things to come nor height nor depth or any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord."
Finally, John 3:16. "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believe in him should not perish but have everlasting life."
Now we just take a moment of silence. If you'd like to pray, you're more than welcome to. Take that moment of silence, you're welcome to as well.
Bow your heads. God, you created an amazing man. One person that Sam came into someone's life that he did not touch in a positive way.
did a marvelous job, Lord. You spent your time with Sam. Everybody here has been impacted by Sam, Lord. That's what your word. That is. It definitely doesn't seem like this. Lord, you are outside of time. It's something that we can't even understand ourselves. Something amazing is about to happen through this. God, I pray for Sam's family. God, I pray for everybody around right now. Over our hearts, just feeling so ripped. How could this happen? Why? Why would you allow this to happen, Lord? But it's for some good reason. Some incredible reason. Sam's up there right now looking at us. I'm sure he'd tell us not to be crying. Just think of all the pep talks he'd have for all of us. He was that one guy every single lifting session, running session, he was there to encourage us. Hey guys, we got this. Let's go. God, I ask that you'd be able to come to all of our lives right now, and the family's lives, Lord, and fill us up with that perfect love, that the only love that could ever fill us up is that, Lord. And I pray that love would come down in all of our hearts. Lord, I pray for his parents. They lost their little boy. God, I pray you touch them up. I know they know you, Lord. Everybody here on this team knew he was going to the NFL, Lord. He was going to make... He was just going to do an incredible job in the NFL, Lord. He was going to be the best punter there. He was the best punter here. Punters are people too, man. Sam doesn't want us to be crying right now. Lord, I just want to lift up the unbeliever right now. I pray that you understand that there is not a single day that is for sure. Every one of us, we might leave this place, and it is not for sure we go home. There is not a single day that's given. You might disagree, Lord, but someone here might disagree with that, but we call it a present for a reason. It is a gift, Lord. You feel air in our lungs. Lord, I pray that you give us the strength to positively impact someone like you have allowed Sam to impact. Lord, if we can even be half of the man that Sam was. Lord, the old Sam I am. We love you, Sam. I pray that your will be done, Lord. I'm already feeling the presence of my team. We're a closer team now because of this. Lord, you have a perfect plan. And I pray that we all can trust in on that. Lord, it's only your love and your strength that's going to get us through this. Lord, I ask for you for now. I miss you, Sam.
At this point in time, I'd like to do a little bit of small group prayer just around you, because there's a lot of people obviously that have been impacted by this death. So we want to spend some time just with two or three people around you, if you would just gather in groups, and we'll specifically spend just a brief few moments praying for Sam's family, for the Michigan State family that also has an extreme loss, for Husker football coaches and players as they are heading into the season, and then thinking about the fan base that lost one of the greatest. So if you would, just in two or three, I'll guide you on those 2 or 3 minutes. So grab the people around you, and we'll spend some time in prayer. Let's go ahead and spend the next couple minutes praying for Sam's family. spend the next few minutes praying for the Michigan State family. Lost one of their own. Spend the next few minutes praying for the Husker football coaches and players as they head into the season without one of their own. Take another 10 seconds or so. If Sam were here, I know that he would have something that he would want all of us to know and to believe. For an opportunity to hear that message, we're going to hear from one of his near and dear friends, Zach Darlington, and he's going to share just briefly about that same message that Sam put his hope in. So, Zach Darlington.
When I got the news this morning, I think I was probably like a lot of people, where I was just kind of numb. Because that kind of thing doesn't happen to folks. Everyone knows Foles, and there's something different about him. He just had a presence about him. There's going to be a hole on our team now, and it's not going to be filled because people like Foles don't come around often. He's probably the hardest worker that I've ever been around. But most of all, he was probably one of the greatest guys I've ever been around. I think that everyone can attest to that. talking to one of my buddies, Luke Gifford, this morning. I found out, and I was very bitter, and I was very angry, because I knew how much of an impact not only did he have on my life, but that he had on everyone in Nebraska. Because Foltz was the absolute best representative of what being a Husker football player could ever be about. And I know that it hit me because Friday I sat in his locker with him after the workout. We clowned around and joked around and talked, and he said he was going to a camp, and I just assumed I'd see him Monday. I just keep realizing I'm not going to see him again. And it's killing me. But then when I talked to Robbie, he reassured me one thing, was that I will see him again, because Foltz cared about his faith dearly, and he loved Jesus Christ with his whole heart. So one day I will see him in heaven. So I was willing to share today that if Foltz were here, he would want you guys to realize that in the blink of an eye, it can all change. We've all seen that. We all realize that, because no one expected this to happen. I think he'd want us to live every day like it was our last, because I know that that's how he approached every workout, every drill, every meeting, every interaction with anyone that he was ever with. It just constantly doesn't feel real. So if you guys would let me, I'd like to take a moment just to pray and just talk to God for you guys. Bow your heads, please. Lord Jesus, everyone's hurting right now. Their hearts are broken. Their lives are shattered. But there's no greater rock than you. And I know that right now, Foltz is looking down. Because I know that the relationship that he had with you, and I there's not a shadow of a doubt in my heart that he's up there right next to you right now. I think that everyone is sad and just broken because we weren't ready to give him up. He was such a great person. Lord, I just pray that you'll be with his family. I can't imagine the loss that they're taking. If I thought he was a great guy in my life, I can't imagine having a son like that. A true gentleman and a representative of Christ. I pray that you be with his friends and the team here and the people in the community and the lives that he impacted. I pray that you just constantly be a reminder that we do have another chance to see him. I pray that everyone will live their life like that. I pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Zach, thank you.
This was a passage of scripture read earlier, but I'll read it again. In John chapter 11, verse 25 and 26, Jesus says, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And everyone who lives and believes in me shall never die." Do you believe this? Sam believed in this. And he is with God right now. It's not a past tense thing. Sam is alive today, but he is with the Father because his belief in Jesus. Do you believe this? It's a truth that we all must wrestle with, and I'm so thankful for the testimony that we have in Sam Foltz. As we near the end of our time together, I want to open it up, and if anyone has anything to say as a memory, the man that Sam is, or a funny story, or a great moment on the field, open mic time. We'll open this up a little bit, and then we'll close it down briefly. So if anybody has something, they can step to the front and share. I just ask that everybody not let this end here, or today, or this week, or this month, or this year. But remember Sam forever. You know, don't let his memory be gone. Keep talking about great things he did, the great man he was. I mean, remember him always, and don't forget about his family, you know. And us guys, let's use each other to lean on each other, you know, and do something special this year for Sam. And just reach out constantly. Don't let this go by the wayside, you know. Remember him for who he was, and remember he passed away trying to get better. I mean, how typical of Foltz is that? You know, just he was trying to get better, and you know, so you know, I just, you know, it's gonna be hard for all of us in the coming weeks. So you know, stick with each other, keep doing great things in Foltz's memory. You know, I'll remember him forever. He was gonna be next to me at the altar on my wedding day. You know, he was my best friend in the world. I mean, but and it's, it still hasn't sunk in yet. You know, I'm just sitting here like I don't really think this is happening, but it is. And you know, we're not gonna see him again until, you know, we get to go to heaven like him. So just live your life, you know, and in the way you think Foltz would, and work hard and stay humble, just like he would and he was known for. So thanks everybody for coming out. This is great. I mean, if there had been more time, I'm sure there'd been even more people here, because that's, you know, how much he meant and the way he carried himself, and what better place to have it right in front of Brooke Behringer right here. I mean, they talk about a guy who Sam resembled, it's him right there. So just don't forget Sam, and thanks everybody for coming out.
Afraid, but Sam took me right under his wing.
and he said, hey, just it's okay. Like, I promise you things are going to be okay and things are going to be good with him. And I knew it for sure. And everyone knows here. That guy, he doesn't want us to be crying right now. He wants us to really be just thankful. And that kid, I thanked him every single day. And I remember the last thing he said to me, he just says, you know, hey, I'll see you later. I'll see you on Monday. I love you, brother. And I would be, God, this shouldn't have happened. I wanted to see him Monday. So did all of us. He meant the world to us. He really did. And I am so sorry for him and his family. I really am. My thoughts and prayers are for him. We truly all do care about him. This is why we're all here. Because he impacted every single one of our lives. I want to thank you guys all for coming here. Like, this would mean the world to him right now. And it does. I guarantee you that.
Competition, the one thing he takes out of it, he makes sure that he doesn't let anybody else affect him. He wants to go there and do what he does. He doesn't want to do anything differently. He doesn't want to do anything like anybody else. He wanted to be just Sam. And I think that's the one thing that I'm going to take away from him. And I'm going to be me. I'm going to take what he said and take his wisdom and try and become the best, not only the best football player, not only the best punter, but the best person that I can be, because that's what Sam did. He cared about everybody that he worked with. He cared about everybody that was on the team. He cared about all the community. And Sam was when I went on my official visit, Sam was a big influence on me when I was here, and he told me how great it was. And I believed him, and I couldn't be more grateful to have known him as a person. And I'm gonna do my best to follow up what he did here, and there's no way I could ever replace him, but just knowing that I had the opportunity to work with him even for a short amount of time, that was only 2.5 months, knowing that I became a better person in that short period of time, I am a better person because of Sam. And I just wanted to thank him, and I thank God for everything that I've had, and I know that he's looking down on me, and he's gonna I'm gonna try and make him and God proud. So thank you, guys.
Anybody else? Don't be shy. I need to hear it. His family needs to hear it. Whoever watches this show later on tonight needs to hear it. So please, someone come up. Don't be shy. We need to hear it. Anything else?
thing that stood out the most about him was he was humble. And I think that's a word that we use too much and we don't know the meaning of it. And I think I just want to encourage all of you and encourage myself, like, during this time to just be humble like Sam was. He always had a smile on his face. He always was just down to have a good time. He was just so kind and humble. There's nothing else to say about him, so I just encourage you guys with that.
You know, when I found out the news this morning, it really, really shocked me, just as everybody else. You know, the thing about folks was, 2 years ago, I was on the punt team. I was on the shield. And the thing about the shield is you stand in front of the punter so that he doesn't get hit. And anytime that I had a bad block or whatever it may be, it was never like, Zach, get it together, Zach, do this, or Zach, do that. It was always my bad, like, I got you. Like, don't worry about it. He's just the type of dude that just lifts you up. And I think, you know, we can all say, like, on our team, there's different cliques, there's different friend groups. And Sam Foltz, he's not my best friend, but he's a guy that I definitely call a brother. Because he's a dude that doesn't matter who it is, he's talking to anybody on the team. He's a guy that's selfless. He's a guy he's a motivator. And, you know, the news, it hit me hard because, like I said, I mean, seeing the relationships that he's created here, seeing the type of person that he is, seeing all you guys out here today, it's crazy. And I hate public speaking, but I felt like I had to say something. I felt like I had to say, you know, that Sam Foltz, he meant a lot to this team. He meant a lot to Nebraska's in general. And I know that we'll be playing for 27 this year, regardless. Every single practice, every single game, you know, he's going to be there with us. I have no doubt. I have no doubt that he's looking down on us right now. And that's all I can say. He's a great guy.
Anybody else?
As we wrap this up, we need to know that any second, our time may come. Sam was ready for that time because he looked upon Jesus. Jesus died, but 3 days later he rose again, proving that everything that he had done was enough to please God. None of us can please God on our own, but if we put our trust in that, then yes, we can know God as soon as we die. We can be with God in heaven where Sam is. We can rejoin with number 27. So my encouragement is, do you believe this? I want to thank Kyron Williams. This was generated by him. God put this on his heart this morning. He was faithful to that. And I want to thank you all for coming out. And we're going to finish with one more song on the back of the sheet that was handed out.
Thank you.
Thank you all for coming. Stay around and encourage one another as long as you need. Have a good rest of your afternoon.
Let's break it up. Let's say as a team.
Everyone.
Everybody.
Everyone wants to come.
We're all family. We're all one team. We all wear that same red.
News people too, come on.
Let's go.
Hands up.
Let's go.
Hands up. Hands up. Hands up. Sam on me. Sam on three. One, two, three. Sam!